No, no, no. I did not cut down the cherry tree, and I have no idea why you think I did.
This is a cultivated plum. Now, how do I know it's a plum? Well, they call it a plum. But it's good size. It has a pit that is ovalish, thick. And it has a bloom. What's a bloom? Well, the bloom is that white key you see right here. That's called a bloom. So that is a plum. That's pretty easy to tell apart. Now, here is a cultivated cherry. So there's the cherry. And here's the cherry pit. Cherry does not have a bloom. And the pit's kind of a little more towards the round side. Now, it's pretty easy for you and me to tell these apart. That's the plum, this is the cherry. Well, the botanists, you know, they have a hard time telling these apart, which probably only goes to show what a little education can do. And the reason is they're in the same family. This is the prunus, this is the prunus. Prunus, well, yeah, you know prunuses. Prunes, like prunes. A prune is a dried plum. And they're all from the family prunus. So, okay, botanists may have a hard time, so let's put this one in here. Well, what is that? Well, these two are pretty close to the same size, aren't they? Yeah, a little different. This one's got a bit of an indentation. This one's a little round. Well, there's your cultivated cherry. This is a Chickasaw plum. And there's the seed, which is a little in between here. So you can tell that on this size, perhaps, it's a little hard to tell the difference between this prunus, and this prunus, whereas the dried one is pretty easy to tell apart because it's dried. So what are we looking at today? Well, we're looking at these. These are your little wild cherries, usually your pin cherry, your black cherry, and your choke cherry, and they're all about the same size. Let's take a look at them. Quite small. See that? Now the flavors vary among the three, from bitter to sweet to, well, choke cherries are called choke cherries for a good reason. They make your mouth dry. So there we have the differences, right there. Plum, plum, cherry, cherry. These are the ones we're going to be looking at today in the field. And prunus, remember, prunes, prunus, big family. How big is it? Well, let's look. This happens to be a small branch of a black cherry tree. What I'll show you here is, see how these berries are arranged. Put this down. You've got a stem, which is actually called a raceme. Then off that, you have little branches with your cherries. And that's the same configuration you're going to find with black cherries and pin cherries. Your choke cherries are different. Your choke cherries have got a cluster of fruit, not a raceme of fruit. Take a closer look at this. There we go. See your stem with the little cherries come up? Now you can see the red ones are not ripe yet, and the black ones are ripe. And shiny, and good size. These tend to be sweet, and you can eat them off the tree with only a trace of bitterness, this particular species. Pin cherries are bitter, and choke cherries are just full of astringency. Usually all three of these are used cooked, although you can eat these. And this one also has some medicinal purposes. Before we go out in the field, let's talk about leaves just a couple more. They all have fine teeth around the edge, but the pin cherry is fat in the bottom. The choke cherry is fat in the middle, and the black cherry is fat at the end. So your pin cherry's got the widest part down near the bottom of the stem. The choke cherry's leaf is just about an even oval with the fattest part in the middle, and the black cherry has the fattest part at the very end. Now you may have to look at several leaves on a tree to get a consensus, because they're not all quite consistent, but if you look at several leaves on a tree of these species, you can figure out which one of these it is just by the leaf shape.
Cherry trees are not large trees. They'll go anywhere from being a shrub up to 25 or 30 feet, depending upon the species. Of course, we're talking about wild cherry trees here, not cultivated ones. And this happens to be a black cherry. Depending upon where you live, you can have one, two, or three cherries. Common where I grew up, of course, were choke cherries. But here in Central Florida now, these are black cherries. And they're also, I tell you, black cherries are at the very, very end of their range. Cherry trees tend to look alike. So once you find one, you've kind of found them all, although there are some variations. The bark tends to have lateral marks. See this? Little cross hatchings here? Here we have lateral marks. And here too. Those tend to turn into verticals. Yeah? And then they split. So you first start getting horizontal marks, then you get vertical marks, and then they split and they turn into what's called some hatching. Some people think they look like, eventually it'll look like burnt potato chips, like over here, down here. The fruit is on what's called a raceme. In other words, you have a little stem and then several fruits off that particular stem, and it's a long stem. Your pin cherries and your black cherries tend to have this, whereas your choke cherries tend to have a cluster. As far as taste, well, let's see here. These are black cherries. They are edible off the tree. Small. You do not eat the seeds, you only eat the fruit, the pulp. As far as leaves go, this is a black cherry, remember? So this one's going to be the biggest towards the end, towards the top, and it is. If it were a pin cherry, it'd be the largest down where my thumb is. And if it were a choke cherry, the leaf would be largest in the middle. But this is the black cherry, so its widest part is near the top.
On this very damp and mosquito-y morning, let's itemize the wild cherries, and we start with identification. Cherries are a shrub to a small tree. They have horizontal marks on the bark. Then as they grow, they develop vertical fissures. And then the horizontal marks and the vertical fissures combine to make a checkering, particularly on the older parts of the tree, often near the bottom. The bark can be brown, gray, or black, and usually smooth, but can also be shaggy and chippy. The leaves are simple with fine teeth. Remember, the pin cherry is fat at the bottom, the choke cherry is fat in the middle, and the black cherry is fat on top. The black cherry's fruit is ripe when it's black. That's convenient. It's a sweet and edible off the tree. The pin cherry's fruit is red when it's ripe and it's bitter on the tree. And the choke cherry is red or black when it's ripe and it's just very astringent. The black and pin cherries, remember, they have their fruit in a raceme, which is kind of like a long tube, whereas the choke cherry has this fruit in a cluster. Time of year. Early summer in the south, late summer, fall in the north. Environment. Woods, thickets along roads and fields. More towards the well-drained side than the wet side. In fact, I've never seen a cherry tree in a soggy area. Method preparation. Black cherries can be eaten right off the tree, although they're slightly bitter. They can all be cooked and made into a jam, a jelly, a sauce, or a wine. You don't have to remove the seeds when you're cooking them, but later on, strain the juice and seeds apart and just use the juice. Thanks for joining me here in my 85th video on Eat the Weeds, this time about wild cherries. If you want to know more about wild cherries or 500 plants, you can go to eattheweeds.com and read about them. So until next time, this is Green Deane. I want you to think green, I want you to eat green, I want you to live green, and stay away from cherry trees with axes. Toodles.